here at this time. Many churches have scaled down, even canceled Sunday services because of the pandemic. But this year, some Easter services are coming back. Joining us now to talk about what they're doing different this year is the senior pastor of North Scottsdale United Methodist Church, Dave Rennick. Pastor Rennick, thanks for being with us.
Thank you, Christina.
So, first of all, before we get into what's different this year, tell me how the last year has been for you and your congregation there.
Well, I think the big word is isolation. It started about 2 weeks in March when we did shut down the denomination, as the United Methodist Church did, almost across the whole continent. But we began doing worship services like a lot of people did, with meetings through Zoom. We learned a lot about technology, stuff that I'd never learned when in seminary. But with that, we begin to learn a lot more about what's available when it comes to technology, how we ran our meetings, bringing people in a little bit closer to be connected as much as we can. From there, we started to do some video recording. And so the service would be video recorded, not so much live on Zoom, because we were dealing with issues like bit rates and all different things that we had not even used before. Where we are today, though, is we've been utilizing a service called live streaming. There's several streaming companies that are out there. And so we're using one of them to actually do our worship service live from in our sanctuary with a worship team that allows them people to engage the service from their home. And then we do a fellowship time with Zoom after the service. What we've been doing the last 2 weeks is really a time to start looking at what does it mean to reopen the church for in-person worship.
Wow.
To get there, we've been doing drive-in parking lot worship services on Sunday mornings while we were also still doing the live stream recording. But where we are now is last week and this week, we are training some of our ushers and hospitality team how to bring in folks to make sure that everyone is masked and social distancing and such.
Yeah, Pastor Ryan, let me ask you this. Normally when you go to a service, there's a choir, and there's a lot going on. How do you maintain that? Can you? Have you been able to during all this?
Very slowly. Basically, what we did for the greatest part of last year was to show recordings of our choir singing throughout the year for many years over. But until recently, we now have a small group of choir members who are singing spaced out in our choir loft. Everybody is masked, well mic'd, and being able to provide that, at least that singing experience. We are asking our congregants right now not to participate in singing. Now you can get a hum in there if that works for you. But we are learning that for us, it's a big concern about the air particles that we've learned about COVID-19.
Thinking back to this time last year, what was last Easter like?
Last week or last Easter was a little lonely, a little anxious. I did that from my home. I believe it might have been from my backyard. And, yet it was still in that way of using Zoom. So it was nice to have that interaction with folks. It was important for us to celebrate what we call the Eucharist or communion or the Lord's Supper with bread and with juice. And we asked folks to bring that. We believe that God can do some wonderful things and bless those elements. So wherever we were, life was that sanctuary space for us to celebrate and be connected in that sacred meal.
So fast forward to this year, this Easter, things are a lot different. Things are moving in a positive direction as far as COVID is concerned. I saw you guys were doing kind of like a drive-through experience.
Last Saturday, we did a drive-through, basically a kind of a Stations of the Cross or sharing the story of Holy Week. It went really well. Folks were really moved by that. This week, as we get closer to Easter itself, we do have a Under the Stars worship service at 7 o'clock on Friday that will be capturing the Stations of the Cross. And then on Sunday, we are having two drive-through, drive-in worship services, but really it's going to be outdoor service at 7 and 8:30, and we're asking folks to make reservations for that.
Okay, great to know.
Mm-hmm.
How do you make those reservations, by the way?
Folks can go to our website, nsumc.com.
All right, anything else you want to add before people, as we head into this Easter weekend?
Really appreciate the support of the local congregation, our community. Easter is that story of deliverance and new life, and we are looking forward to those new beginnings that are before us.
All right, Senior Pastor, North Scottsdale United Methodist Church, Dave Rennick. Thank you so much, Dave. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
going to be good to see people back in service.